As we have completed with chapter 1, that is integers, and hope you all have done everything in your fair notebook. Now we'll start the second chapter, that is fraction and decimals. As you all are already aware of the two words fraction and decimal. What is a fraction? A number which represents a part of a whole, as we have studied in the junior classes. We can also say that a fraction is written as P upon Q, where P and Q are whole numbers and Q is not equal to 0. For example, we can have 2 upon 7, 5 upon 9, 12 upon 7, 1 upon 5, etc. Now comes the classification of fractions. Different types of fraction we are knowing with the name. What is the first type? That is the proper fraction. A fraction in which numerator is less than denominator means, for example, you are having 2 upon 5. This is numerator, 2 is numerator and 5 is denominator. 2 is less than 5. So this is an example of proper fraction. 3 upon 7. Here also 3 is less than 7. Again, 15 upon 29, 37 upon 105. Anything like this in which numerator is less than denominator will come in the category of proper fraction. Other type is improper fractions. A fraction in which numerator is greater than and equal to denominator. Greater than means 5 upon 2. Numerator should be greater than denominator. Other example is 11 upon 7. Again here, numerator is greater than denominator. 57 upon 12. Again here, numerator is greater than denominator. But just see here, equality sign is also there. Means 5 upon 5. 5 upon 5 will also come in improper fraction. 12 upon 12 will also come in improper fractions. Next is mixed fraction. A fraction having two parts, a whole part and a proper fraction, is known as mixed fraction. For example, 3, 2 by 5. 3 is the whole part. 3 is the whole part and this 2 upon 5 is the proper fraction. So in mixed fraction, we are having two parts. One is the whole part and the fractional part. You can see other example. 9, 4 upon 7, 215, 3 upon 4, 7, 12 upon 19. Next is decimal fraction. A fraction whose denominator is 10, 100, thousands are called decimal fractions. For example, we are having 15 upon 100, 2 upon 10, 75 upon 1000. These are the examples of decimal fractions. Next is like fraction. Two or more fractions having same denominator. For example, 3 upon 5, 2 upon 5, 11 upon 5, 16 upon 5. All these fractions you can see that they are having denominator as 5 only. So these all are like fractions. Now next is unlike fractions. Two or more fractions having different denominators are known as unlike fraction. For example, 2 upon 5 is one fraction. Other one is 3 upon 7. 5 and 7 are denominators and they are different. We can take more examples. 7 upon 12, 9 upon 17. All the denominators are different, so they will come, they are known as unlike fractions. We can also say that 3 upon, we can take 9, no, not 9, 3 upon 11. Although 3 and 3 are same numerators, but they are having different denominators, so they all will come in the category of unlike fractions. Comes the equivalent fraction. Fractions having same value are called equivalent fractions. For example, we are having 2 upon 5. Next is 4 upon 10, then 6 upon 15, 20 upon 50. These all are equivalent fractions. How so? See, 2 upon 5 is there? Fine. 4 upon 10. This is a fraction. If we divide numerator and denominator by 2, what answer will get? 2 upon 5. So this is again in the lowest term or in the standard form, this is 2 upon 5 only. So this and this are equivalent fractions. Same here, 6 upon 15 is there. If we divide numerator and denominator by 3, what answer will get? 2 upon 5. So it is in the standard form or in the lowest term it is 2 upon 5 only. So this is again equal to 2 upon 5. These all 3 are equivalent. Same here, if both are divided by 10, it will be equal to 2 upon 5. Means all the fractions in the lowest term is equal to 2 upon 5. So all these fractions are equivalent. Now, whatever we have done till now, let's see the questions based on these topics. Write the natural number from 3 to 19. What fraction of them are even numbers? Means we have to write the numbers from 3 to 19. You know, numbers from 3 to 19 will be how? 3, 4, 5 and so on till 19 we have to write. How many numbers will be there? If we count from 3 to 19, we are having in total numbers we are having equal to 17. If we count all the numbers from 3 to 19, we are having 17 numbers. From these, we have to take out the even numbers. What even number we have here? 4, then 6, then 8 and so on till we are having 18. If you count all these numbers, you will get even numbers equal to 8. So they are asking for the fraction. So required fraction is required fraction will be equal to what is the total number of total numbers we are having? 17. So total number will go in the denominators and they are asking for even number fractions. So how many even numbers we are having? 8. So 8 upon 17 is the required answer. Now next question is, what fraction of an hour is 35 minutes? Means out of 1 hour 35 minutes are there. So what is the fraction for it? You know, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes and they are asking for 35 minutes. How much part of 1 hour is 35 minutes? So required fraction will be equal to 35 minutes out of 60 minutes. This is your required fraction and you know both can be divided by 5. So we can write in the lowest term divided by 5 divided by 5. You get 7 and you get 12. So 7 upon 12 is the answer for this. Question 3 is, convert the fractions into improper fraction. We are having a mixed fraction. What is this? It's a mixed fraction. And we have to convert it into improper fraction. You all know how to convert. 2, 7 upon 9 will be equal to. We have to multiply the denominator by the whole part. We have to multiply the denominator by whole part, that is 9 into 2. And then we have to add the numerator, that is 7. And whole upon we go for 9. We have already done these things in the junior classes. So just multiply 9 to the 18 plus 7 upon 9. So your answer is 25 upon 9, which is a improper fraction. Next is 5, 4 upon 11. Again, we have to convert it to improper fraction. So you all know how to convert. 5, 4 by 11 will be equal to, we have to multiply these two terms and we have to add the numerator. That is 5 multiplied by 11 plus 4. And whole upon again 11 only. That is 55 plus 4 upon 11. And your answer will be 59 upon 11. Now, question number 4 is, convert fractions into mixed fraction. We are having 73 upon 8, which is a improper fraction. And now we have to change improper fraction into mixed fraction. How we will change? We have to divide. You all have done in the junior classes. 73 divided by 8. 8 times is 72, and what is left with? 1. What is this? This is quotient. What is this? This is remainder. And what is this? This is divisor. And when we convert improper fraction into mixed fraction, our answer is something like Q R upon D. What is Q here? We are having Q as 9. So your answer will be 73 upon 8 is equal to, first what we have to write? Q. What is Q here? 9. That is the whole part. And then what is R? Remainder. What is R here? 1 upon, what is divisor here? 8. So this is your answer. Now again we have to convert 94 upon 13 in mixed fraction. So again we have to divide. Divide 94 by 13. You know 13 sevens are how much? 91. What is left with? 3. Here again, what is Q? 7 is Q, that is the quotient. What is R? Remainder, that is 3. And 13 is the divisor. And you know answer is in the form of Q R upon D. So your answer is 94 upon 13 is equal to, in the form of Q R upon D. Just to memorize this, Q is what? 7. 3 is the remainder and divisor is 13. So this is your answer. Next question you are having is fill in the blanks. First part is 3 upon 7 is equal to blank upon 35. What we have to fill here, we have to see. Now, you can see here equality sign is there, means these two fractions are equivalent fraction. Right? 3 upon 7 is equal to something, some number we have to write out here, upon 35. So how we will judge what number will come here? So you will see the denominators, because we are having denominator over here. 35 is there. So what we need to multiply 7 to get 35? Obviously, what answer we get? 7, 5 is 35, means we have multiplied 5 in the denominator to get 35. And if 5 is multiplied in denominator, so we have to multiply 5 in the numerator only. 5 3 is 15. So your answer is 15. Okay. Now let's see here. Here we are having 30 upon 18. And in numerator we are having 5. Right? And nothing we are having over here. What number will come here? So just see. We are having numerators 30 and 5. What work we have to do on 30 so that we can get 5? Obviously we have to divide because 5 is less than 30. So we have to divide 30 by some number to get the answer as 5. And you all know that 30 divided by 6 will give you 5. So we have to divide denominator also by 6 only. Now 18 divided by 6 will give you answer as 3. So your answer is?
Yes, that's it for today, and rest we'll deal tomorrow.